This is going to be the perfect seasoning you ever use for your salmon steak. Trust me, it is so juicy, delicious, and above all, tasty. Keep watching ahead, do not go away. Hello guys, and welcome back to my kitchen. It's Cooking with Claudie here, and on today's episode I will be showing you how to make blackened salmon with homemade blackened seasoning. If you're new here, a very special welcome to you. To my returning subscribers, thank you so much for the support, the likes, the comments. In fact, you guys are the best. But if you haven't yet subscribed, please take a moment to hit the subscribe button, turn on the notification bell, so when I post any of my videos, you're going to receive that alert, and of course you will not miss out. Right here for the homemade blackened seasoning, we have some salt, cayenne pepper, paprika, oregano, garlic powder, onion powder, and thyme. You will be needing black pepper for this recipe, but I will be using the freshly cracked black pepper. If you don't have the freshly cracked black pepper, you can use the powdered pepper and add that to it. Also, we have some butter right here. Like, I'll be using like 2 tablespoons, and our beautiful steak, that's a salmon steak, freshly looking. Start first by pat drying it and taking off all that extra water or moisture from it. Then we are going to begin seasoning. For this part, you can skip it if you don't want to. I just wanted to have that smoky flavor, so I'm adding my liquid smoke here. You can skip this part if you don't want it, or if you want this liquid smoke, I'll be dropping the Amazon link there and you can get it. So now melt about 2 tablespoons of butter. Right here, I'm using unsalted butter. If you like, you can use salted butter. It just depends on what you want at that particular time. So just melt the butter until it is completely melted. Then we are going to pan grill our salmon. Pan grill the salmon 5 minutes each side until you have that blackened color or a dark brown color. Right now, the other side has been cooked. After 5 minutes, I'm just going to flip it all over so that the other side cooks for another 5 minutes. While it's cooking, that little butter that is there, I'm just going to baste it so it stays moist and juicy. And now it has been fully blackened. Take it out from the fire. For my veggies here, I'm using this Chinese veggies. It's called yu choy. I love it. I so love this particular veggies. So in a pot of boiling water, I'll just put the veggies inside. If you like, you can slice it, but I just like putting it whole like this. So cover the pot and bring to a boil for about 3 minutes. And after 3 minutes, take it out from the boiled or hot water, then run it through cold water so that it doesn't overcook and it's going to maintain that beautiful green color. So to cook the veggies in a pot, just add some cooking oil, then saute some garlic, add some soy sauce. I'll be dropping the link in the description box. Right here I have some oyster sauce. If you want, you can put like a pinch of salt, but the salt and the oyster sauce and the soy sauce is just okay for me. So I'm just putting in some freshly cracked black pepper there. Stir everything until everything has been perfectly combined, just like for about a minute. And our veggies is ready to go. I love these veggies, guys. It's so, so good, especially with rice. Anything is so, so yummy. And right now, it's still so crunchy. I'll be serving this too with some baked rice. If you want the baked rice recipe, I'll also be dropping the link for you in the description box. And right now, it's time to serve our beautiful salmon, the rice, the veggies, and we have our carrot and peas there, seasoned with salt, just like a pinch of salt. I'll just put it in there and get ready to serve. It's looking so beautiful and flavorful too. It has that smoky flavor. It's just like it came out from the barbecue or the smoker. I'm just gonna cut it right here and let's give it a try. It is so, so flaky, which shows that it has been perfectly cooked. Look at that. So, 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 so yummy. So guys, you definitely have to try out this recipe, and trust me, it is worth trying. And don't bother if you're looking for a particular recipe for salmon steak, maybe blackened, pan grilled, baked. You can use this same seasoning and you are going to love it. So guys, thank you so much for watching to this point, and keep trusting my recipes. Until we meet again in my next video, please stay safe. Bye-bye.